Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us see how to set up a WordPress MultiSite eCommerce on AWS through Bitnami WordPress Image. WordPress MultiSite makes it simple to manage multiple WordPress websites from the same server and interface. It means through a single WordPress deployment, you can manage multiple websites. The multi-site configurations can be enabled in AWS by using the Bitnami WordPress MultiSite Image. Bitnami certifies that its images are secure, up-to-date, and packaged using industry best practices. The multi-site setup enables us to go to market in a short duration. The new websites can be launched with minimal effort. We are going to use Woocommerce plugin to enable the e-commerce functionalities. Woocommerce is an open source e-commerce plugin for WordPress. It is designed for small to large sized online merchants using WordPress. Let us now see how to do that. As a first step, let's create a AWS free account. Ignore this step if you already have the account. The free tier is for 12 months. Pay as you go beyond this period. My recommendation is to ensure free tier services are used and also the resources are stopped after the usage to avoid the fees if you are using this for learning. Okay, once the account is ready, go to log into the account, search for EC2. Now we need to launch a EC2 instance. For that, click on instances. Then launch instance. Now, yeah, go to AWS Marketplace, search for WordPress. Here you can see the first one is WordPress certified by Bitnami and automatic. So this is not provide by default the multi-site functionality, but you can use this and configure it later. But I am not going with that. I am going with the WordPress multi-site certified by Bitnami and automatic. So it will automatically enable the multi-site for you, functionalities for you. Okay, so here you can see it's a free tier eligible, but it is saying the total the space, like the cost for the EC2 instance. Right now it is free tier because this is within 12 months. Once you cross that limit, you may need to pay for that. Yeah, now you see like it's a general purpose, free tier eligible. So we don't want to pay for now. Okay, click on review and launch. Yeah, see here, like you can see the free tier 0.0 dollar, the cost. So you can verify if anything, all those details here. Once done, you can just go and launch it. Okay, so here you can choose to use the existing key pair or you can create it. So I am going to use new key pair because like this is the one we are going to use it for connecting through SSH. So give some name. Download and keep it safely. It's a private key. Yeah, once that's done, you can click on launch instances. Yeah, this may take some time. We need to wait so to the instance to come up. So yeah, click on here the view instances. So but it will be still initializing, so you need to wait until the instance state change to running and the status checks are completed. So after that you will be able to use the instance. Yeah, this is the public DNS. You can use it or IP address. You can use this to access the consoles, the websites. Okay, here like Bitnami already automatically configured all the groups and policies, everything. But if you want, you can even you can modify those things. And now the instance is ready, running and status check completed. Let me go and try to access it. Copy this IP address. Okay. It's like going to the default website. So this is the website default theme applied. It's not an e-commerce website so far. It is a blogging website. Now let's log into the let's now create a domain so to point to this, because right now we access through IP address. So for my case, I'm going to Cloudflare because I have a custom domain and it is managed through Cloudflare. So I'm going to create some subdomain for that. So most of the cases in real scenario, you need to have a top domain like ecommerce.com. So then you have all the subdomains called store 1.ecommerce.com or store 2.ecommerce.com. But my case, I am somehow, my top domain can't be used. So I am using another subdomain as the base domain. Then on that, again, I am building other subsites. But in your case, you can use the top domain. Yeah, I'm going to use store dot, store dot, copy the IP address. Then it will become a store dot. My case, it is albinsblog.com, store dot albinsblog.com. Save that. It's a A record again. Note that. Now you go and try to access. First you check the DNS, whether it is the changes are reflecting. You can use this DNS checker. Just enter that host name. It's store dot albinsblog.com. Search. You can see the IP address. The A record is reflecting. So the change is fine now. Now let me go and access the domain. You still, if you see, it's redirecting to, the domain is identified, but it's redirecting to IP. So it means that this particular domain is not configured into the WordPress setup. So for that, you go into WP admin. You need to use the username is the user. Now the credential, we need to get it from the AWS console. Go back to AWS console. So if you go here, like click on the top, there is a launch instance. You can click on that. Click on the accents. Then click on instance settings. Then there is something you can see, get system log. Here, like you can see the initial password. So it is just a temporary password. You can change it. For now, I am ignoring it for just a testing purpose. So use this password. You can see there it's a password is there, application password. Copy that. Username is the user. So but change the password like once, first time. Just log in. So this is the look and feel. Like you can have a lot of you have a lot of sections here, just to review that whatever you want. Now go to my sites network admin. So see here, this is the automatic setup, multi-site setup with Bitnami. The network admin and all those configurations are by default enabled. You can see the network settings. If you go to under the settings, if you go to network setup, you can see here there is a default default site. So it's pointing to the IP address. So now what we need to do is we need to change this to our domain name so that it will become a default. For that, go to PuTTY. So first off, we need to have the PuTTY key generated, because PuTTY won't accept that PEM file whatever we downloaded. For that, I'm going into PuTTY key gen, point to that file what you downloaded, the key file that is of type PEM. Then it's fine. Then save the private key. Give some name. Save that. Now you can open PuTTY. So you should be using this key, whatever you generated. Just to go to PuTTY, then create a new connection. So keep the IP address. So you can get the IP address from the console. Yeah, Now you need to go to SSH in the left side. Then after SSH, go to auth, maximize that. You can go to auth. Here if you see, you can select that private key, whatever you generated, select that. Yeah, then one more step, you go under data, specify the name as Bitnami. So that is the username to login. So you can create different users in AWS console. Yeah, store this session so that you can use it later. So just I'm storing it. Yep. Save it and then load it. Yep. Yes. Then yeah. Now you are able to successfully connect through SSH to that instance. CD2 apps, then WordPress, then ST docs. Yeah, you can see here a file called wp-config.php, v8. Yeah, we maybe take a backup first. PA that, so you will come little down. Yeah, you can see the multi-site configuration here. So here you can see the value, IP value. You can replace that with the domain name. My case it is store.albinsblog.com. So that is going to be the base domain. You can have subdomain on this. So most of the cases, you should be keeping a top domain here. Example, albinsblog.com or ecommerce.com. Okay, now let's restart the server. You can use this command, sudo, then go to that SSH, then restart Apache. Okay. Yeah, server restarted. Let's try now. Okay, store.albinsblog.com. Okay, now the change is taking it, but if you see here, it is doing a too many redirects. It's now considering the domain, but the too many. For that, what you need to do is you need to do two things. One is like, first you need to set your master domain to Bitnami. So you can use this specific command. You can cd to particular folder. Execute this bnconfig sudo.bnconfig. Yeah, master hostname. Yeah, you can specify the host name, like here my case it is store.albinsblog.com. Yeah, it will take some seconds to complete. Next up, we need to configure some rewrite rules into the ST access file. The following location, but for me somehow it was not working, so I configured those values in under apps WordPress conf httpd-app.conf file. Yeah, let me open that. Here you can see there is some rewrite rules or redirect rules already there, so we need to copy the redirect rules or the configuration from the console. So let me now go to the console, then you can copy this. So these are all the rules you need to configure. So I'm only copying the second section because the three rules are already there. So if you see here, like on the top it is there, but I'm going to comment this rule is again coming from that set of rules. So I'm commenting out these three rules here. Okay, add whatever you copied, then save it and restart the server. Okay, let's wait now. Okay, the server, yeah, server is restarted. Now let's go and access that. Yeah, now you can see the basic page. So means you are able to access the store through store.albinsblog.com. That is my base domain. Now let me go to WP admin. Here again the user, you can use it. Then the password, like whatever the user password. Login. Yeah, here you can see again. You can same view whatever you seen through the IP address. Now let me go into dashboard, my sites. Yeah, my sites, if you click on that, it will say which is the primary site. My case it's store.albinsblog.com. Now if I go under sites, I'm so far having only one site, that is store. Now you can add new site. Now I'm going to create another site called store.store1. Keep some title. Yeah, you can change the language if required, but I am leaving with that. You can keep the admin email. Okay, add the site. Now it will create another new site. So this is the beauty of the multi-site configuration. So you just this is the step to configure new site, but you need to add your own plugins and all those things. We can we can see that. Now I go to again Cloudflare. I need to configure my new domain. This time I will create a CNAME record with the name store1.store, because normally it will be store1. But my case, because I am already working on the subdomain, I need to keep that name also, store1.store.albinsblog.com. The target going to be store.albinsblog.com. If you do this, like what is the benefit is you have multiple website, let's say 100 website. Tomorrow the IP address changes, easily you can manage it. Only one entry you need to change. Otherwise, every entry you need to go and change. That's the beauty of this configuration. Now, let me go and access it. So it's again coming the default page, store.albinsblog.com also coming. So now we have a multi-site, two sites, one base site, one subdomain site. Like this, you can configure how many sites you want. It is very easy, but maybe this is the part one of this video. I will explain how to enable the e-commerce and how to do the setup in the next video. So now if you see here in the console, you can see two sites are. There one is store.albinsblog.com, another one is store1.store.albinsblog.com. This is the default behavior. You can configure the multi-sites, enable the multi-site sites based on the subdomain. But even you can still enable the multi-sites through subfolder. So maybe in the part 2 video we can see how to enable through the subfolders. Yeah, that's all for today. Thanks all for watching the video. See you in the next video.